Hamba, 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 no socolo, coli, 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 cuyai, wagapa.
Oh my
gapa,
God.
Gapa, so duelo,
nice music.
Hamba, no socolo.
Half caste in Zimbabwe was superior to an African.
Are you serious?
Oh, that was a different class. In Zimbabwe, Bazungu area, African area, Indian area, half caste area. When we reached Uganda, you used to see some men with the, or women with the Bazungus. Openly, nobody was bothered.
Too much freedom.
In Zimbabwe, it was impossible.
To African to date a white.
How do you start? We want prison. You know this Yvonne Chaka Chaka song? Wema Jamin.
Oh.
Open Komboti. Wema Jamin. Open Komboti. African beer. That is the beer which we drink, we're drinking.
You were not supposed
to drink this beer, Beru beer, Nairu beer. No. You Ugandans were very lucky. We are not colonized. We were not colonized. Everything was normal here. Muzungu akora bibye umuchota rati bamumanya nakumumanya. My father was a policeman.
Okay.
A musician he was.
Okay.
He used to play piano accordion, which President Amin used to play.
Yeah.
You know piano accordion?
Yeah, I know. The one that expands and...
Yes, he used to have one.
Hmm.
And I used to attend shows in Harare, which was Salisbury by that time, before independence, with my elder sister and my elder brother.
Yeah.
Then there was a group called the Black Evening Follies. That was the best group. We're doing shows like Bonnie
Uganda.
In Uganda here. This Boni, Ebony.
The Ebonies.
Ebonies.
Yeah.
We're doing that type of shows.
Oh, you used to do that.
That's what brought us out of Zimbabwe. Acting on the stage, and I was still a young boy. I formed my own group because I used to admire the Black Evening Follies.
At what age now?
I think I was just 12. 13 there.
12 years?
Old. Yes, yes.
Just the 12?
Yes, like that. So, some of my brothers were in our second city called Bulawayo.
Bulawayo.
That is our second biggest city in Zimbabwe, apart from Harare. Harare is the main city. So, that was school holidays. I went to visit them. They were working there. From there, when I was just with them, we started singing. We ended up forming a group called the Hot Trio brothers.
Hot Trio Brothers.
Hot Trio Brothers. Oh, became slowly were becoming popular. Now, during that time, that was 1951, when we started that Hot Trio Brothers, 1951. Then Northern Rhodesia, now Zambia.
Now Zambia.
Was very popular. They used to like music from Southern Rhodesia, which is now Zimbabwe.
Oh my God.
Do you know the meaning of Zimbabwe?
I don't know. What's the meaning of Zimbabwe?
In Zimbabwe, there is an area where we don't know who did this building.
Yeah.
Old time building, built of stones. Big, like we see Kabaka Sedubiri.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
But built of stones.
Stones only.
Up to now, still there.
Oh.
That's when Zimbabwe got independence. I think Mugabe decided to call it Zimbabwe, meaning the house of stone, because it is built of stones.
So Zimbabwe means?
House of stone.
House
of stones. Because it was built with the stones, round. Nobody knows.
There is
no cement there, but how they built those stones round to make it a house, nobody knows. That's how we got that name. Zimbabwe, the house of stone. Now, we decided to take a short visit of a month in Northern Rhodesia, now Zambia.
Okay.
We toured all the towns, Ndola, Mufulira, wherever a city is, we were entertaining. Then we ended up at Mufulira town,
okay,
in Zambia. Somebody came to us and said, you people, are you thinking of going to Congo? Said, Congo, where is it? What is Congo? Said, Belgian Congo. It was called Belgian Congo before it became Zaire. It was
Belgian Congo.
Yes.
Okay.
Said, people in Belgian Congo, they love this type of shows you are doing.
Music.
You can be millionaires if you went there. And in Ufuria, that was our last show. We're now thinking of going back home. We said, why don't you try to go?
Let's go.
We went.
You reached Congo?
We reached Congo. Katanga, which is now Elizabethville.
Okay.
It was Elizabethville,
okay.
Now Katanga.
Yeah.
We staged a show there. Very well attended. And while we were having an interval, certain Muzungu, managing director of Belga Cigarettes in Congo there, he said, you people, how long are you staying here in Congo? We said, when we finish our shows, we go back home. He said, but I want to give you a side contract. He said, yes. To advertise our cigarettes. It was like BAT here.
Yeah.
Said, no problem, but we don't smoke.
All of you?
We're not smoking. Only one was smoking.
Okay.
The elder to us. Then he gave us an offer, very good money in francs. Their money was francs.
It was good money.
It was good money. So we staged another show, and we were advertising Belga cigarette. We had a bag full of money like this.
Oh my God.
Then Ernest, who was elder to us, who was smoking and even drinking.
Okay.
We're in our hotel where we're staying. He said, my brothers, look at this bag full of money.
What should we do?
Are we not millionaires now?
Okay.
We said, I think we are.
Okay.
He said, now, I propose that when we go to Leopoldville, which is now Kinshasa.
Kinshasa.
Kinshasa was Leopoldville before it became Kinshasa.
Oh my God.
That is all that time, 1950, 51, 52.
Yeah.
So, because they told us that that is the biggest city, and there we shall make double money than this.
Who's telling? You're telling them?
Some people are telling us.
That you can that make more money?
In the capital city.
Oh my God.
This is just a small town.
Okay.
But
already you're making money.
Yes, but if you go to...
You can make more.
You'll make more money.
You bought the idea.
We forgot even about going to Zimbabwe now.
So you agreed?
We agreed.
Okay.
Then, while he was telling us like that, he bought himself a bottle of whiskey. Some of us were drinking soda.
Yeah.
He drank himself mad. Even by the time we went to sleep, we had to lift him to his room, because we're so excited that we're now millionaires. And the following day, when we finished all our shows and this and that, then he said, how can we carry this bag full of money to go to the capital? After all, we're just going there, make more money, then come back here. So what we should do, let's open an account with this man.
We
leave it in the bank. We take just enough for us to go there and back. We agreed. We banked all the money. Then he asked the bank, how much is this money? Because it was in francs.
Yeah.
If you turn it into... pounds, because we're using pounds in Zimbabwe and in Northern Rhodesia and in Malawi, whatever it is. The amount of money they told us shook us. It was so small.
It was so small?
We're so disappointed.
Yet you thought you were a millionaire?
Yes.
Okay.
We're walking like millionaires.
Okay.
You go to a hotel to eat. We're just asking the most expensive meal. And by that time, in South Africa, there was a group called the Manhattan Brothers, which was having a female singer, Miriam Makeba.
Oh, Miriam Makeba.
She was a member of that
of group.
The best in the Central Africa, in South Africa.
Yeah.
So we started saying, our brothers, Ernest, who are the Manhattan Brothers? To us. Ooh. We are millionaires already.
Okay.
Eh? So we are just going to open our own nightclub. What? But when we're told that figure, the money which is changed to pounds, we said, we are not even going to Kinshasa.
Perform.
Nah. Let's forget, we just go home. So from there, we went to Malawi, staged our shows there. The problem we used to have is the people who come to us and ask, are you going to this place? just like the one who told us to quote to Benjamin Congo. And somebody there, are you going to Tanganyika? He said, Tanganyika, where is Tanganyika? Oh, just our neighbor there, Tanganyika there. He said, mm-hmm. Oh, you make good money there. He said, what currency do they have there now? Well, now, didn't want
to. We're now considering the currency.
Yes.
Because the last time,
The Congo man, we found a big note of 50, 100, you know, that's why it became
too much.
Too much. And when we see 100 francs, for us, we thought it was 100
dollars.
Dollars. We're confused.
It was too much.
Yes. So became a bit
curious
about what currency they use there. So they use pounds. Said, at least we know that it's a full house. We've charged so much. At least we know what we're expecting.
Yeah.
And that one, which confused us, said, let's go. We reached Dar es Salaam. It was our first time to see a Muslim.
Are you sure?
Yes.
In Dar es Salaam?
We don't have Muslims in Zimbabwe.
No mosque?
If they are there, maybe because there are Indians there. But we used to see some funny buildings, but
okay.
Africans, we are Catholic, Protestants, and the other religions, but Christians. That's when we first saw a man with a beard putting a kanzu, which we thought was a dress. We finished our shows there. We
performed in Tanganyika. Then where did you
get that idea? That was now.
Next move.
No, you see, you just get people just come and say, are you going, you know? Now we're thinking of going back home.
To Zimbabwe.
Okay, somebody. A Muzungu, there was a Muzungu who, Peter Colmo. He attended the show. And he came to the stage when we were on interval. He said, hello. You sing like the Mills Brothers of America. You remind me of my country. I come from Kenya, and I'm living in Kenya. I would like you to come to Nairobi. I'll take care of you. Accommodation is on me. I'll make sure I'll book you a good place where you make good money. He said, he's going to give us free food, free transport.
Accommodation.
Why don't you go there?
Hmm.
He gave us his business card. We said we shall contact you. We contacted him, said we are coming. How are you coming? He said, we are coming by easy transport because we don't have money to fly. But when we reach Nairobi, we shall ring you. And we tell you where we are, you come and pick us. He said, fine. We reached Nairobi, we rang him where we are, and he knew the place, he picked us. So he said, you, Shelton, you sing very well as an individual vocalist.
Yeah.
I'm going to get you a job in Inquieta Nightclub. There's a band called Kiko Kids there. It is for my friend.
Okay.
And then these other four, I'll take them to San Chic. I've already got a job there for them. They will entertain there. Only for whites.
Only for whites.
At that time it was only for whites.
Okay.
That was now 1955. We left home from 1952.
Oh my God.
We are going. Our long, long unplanned journey.
It was unplanned?
No. who just wanted to entertain Zambians for one month and to go back home.
So you got a job in Nairobi?
Yes, I was singing in the Inquieta nightclub.
Yeah.
And my other brothers.
As a doing what?
Singing.
MCing.
Singing. This is a dance music now.
Okay.
For me, I was singing songs for dancing.
Mm.
For us. See, these nightclubs, they're not like ours here.
Mm.
Bazogu, in a nightclub, they eat food, they dance, drink, you know.
Mm.
So me, I was singing, dancing music.
For people who are eating and enjoying life.
Yes, in the nightclub.
Mm.
My brothers also were singing, also with that band there.
All right.
Then one time, we said, why don't we, Sundays were not working.
Mm.
Why don't we stage a show for our African people on Sunday?
Mm.
So yeah, that's a good idea. So we booked a hall in Kaloleni, in Kaloleni location, African location. We staged a show, very successful. And now this, how we are coming to Uganda.
Now you're planning your way to Uganda.
No, we didn't know about
you're
Uganda.
You're not yet planning.
No,
but
that show at Kaloleni,
yeah,
the first African show we staged in Kenya.
Mm.
A man called, I wish you had come to my room. Maybe you shall.
Yeah, we shall go there. And see.
Was Ahmed Oduka.
Mm.
He was the deputy director of police band.
Okay.
But that was the band lead, but the band director was Mr. Moon, an Englishman.
Mm.
So Oduka was the assistant. He was even sent for further studies in music because Uganda was getting to independence,
yes,
so that
exactly.
He can take over.
Mm.
So he said, you people, are you coming to Uganda? The same story. Like
you've
everywhere.
You've been rolling on the same story.
Yeah.
Same story. Show
yes.
Off, show.
Yes. Are you coming to Uganda? We said, Uganda? Where is Uganda? He said, just the
neighbor,
border here.
Neighbor,
just
neighbor
here. Oh, Ugandans. This show you are doing here. He said, me, I play music in police band. Then at night, I do part-time job in Kamuru's nightclub at Mengo,
okay,
next to Bulange, part-time.
Mm.
But I want you to come to Uganda. You will not
very
regret.
Okay.
So he said, the same story.
Same story from Congo.
Oh, where?
Zambia.
Maybe when you get to Uganda, somebody again said, oh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So
they will take you to another country.
We started making a joke of it.
Okay.
Then he took our contact and we got his contact.
Same and story.
As soon as he came back to Uganda,
yeah,
he started writing to us. Nearly every week we get a letter from him.
Inviting you.
You come. Are you coming? Then, when we were talking to him, he told us one thing which we never knew. Do you know that for us in Uganda, we've got even kings.
Oh.
African kings.
Hmm.
Got confused. We said, what?
Mm.
Because in Zimbabwe, we were colonized. We only knew the king of Britain as our king.
There's no king.
We had these chiefs who were just used by these Bazungus. Eh?
Yeah.
We said, what? Are you sure? With the palace. He said, Abanang. Tunakugenda mu Uganda.
Together.
We must go to Uganda to African kings.
Yeah.
Mm. We said, after all, our contract is getting finished within 2 months. We are on our way coming.
Mm.
Rest assured, we are coming. We want to see these African kings. that King problem brought us to Uganda would not have bothered.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
King Palace, how?
Mm.
You know, in Zimbabwe?
I've never gone to Zimbabwe.
In Zimbabwe that time, when a drunkard Muzungu is walking towards you and you are having a cap like mine, you have to remove it as he crossing.
Why?
Those people treated us like mad.
That's why Mugabe was too rough.
Don't blame Mugabe. Okay, I don't like the way he did it because things went bad afterwards. But I remember very well one time, as a young boy, my father was admitted in the hospital. So my mother was carrying food for him to the hospital on her head. And I was having my toy car. There were Zungu boys on their motorcycles. They hit the food from my mother's head. Yes. Then they got my... Omuzungu, my friend. Do you know that a half caste in Zimbabwe was superior to an African?
Are you serious?
Oh, that was a different class. In Zimbabwe, Bazungu area, African area, Indian area, half caste area.
You shared the portions?
Yes, different where we stay in different areas.
Bazungu used to stay in their lane.
Yes.
The Africans, pure African used to stay in their lane. Half caste, they also have their lane.
They were important. Half caste, even if you're the same job or maybe you are better qualified than the half caste, he will have to get better salary than you because he is whiter.
Oh my God.
That was there. You see the problem we had?
Yeah.
The same thing in South Africa. Even in Belgian Congo here, it was the same. When we reached Uganda, you used to see some men with the, or women with the Wazungus. Openly, nobody was bothered.
Too much freedom.
In Zimbabwe, it was impossible.
To African to date a white
How do
person.
You start? We want prison.
You cannot date.
Like, no. You don't start. You don't even think of it. Even this beer, you saw, you know this Yvonne Chaka Chaka song? Where my jamming? Upumkomboti. Where my jamming? Upumkomboti. African beer. That is the beer which we drink, we're drinking.
You were not supposed
to drink this beer, Beru beer, Nile beer. No.
What?
Africans had their beer halls, they call them beer halls. For that Mkomboti beer.
It was only for you.
For Africans.
No white.
No white beer. My father was given some few beers on Christmas by his boss, his immediate boss. He had to tie that beer in a way that it doesn't get broken and nobody could see that it is beer. He brought it home. And he would lock himself with my mother to drink two beers for 2 days using even a spoon.
That was the situation?
Yes. Yes.
Too terrible.
You Ugandans were very lucky. We are not colonized.
What?
You were not colonized. Everything was normal here. Muzungu akwarabivye.
Everybody is happy
in his own way.
Too much freedom. Everybody is okay.
Even if you've got a Muzungu girlfriend, people just look at you. We used to see Waganda looking at you.
I didn't see Zimbabwe, no
way. Let's go. I got a camera. You turned the court here. How do you start? Was that bad, my dear friends?
So, Mr. Mazowe, you landed in Uganda.
Now, we rang Mr. Oduka that we are coming, we are boarding a train, shall come by train.
Yeah.
We arrived at Kampala railway station around 1:30. He was there with a lot of musicians from the police band to welcome us.
Okay.
He took us to his house in the barracks, police barracks. Mm. That's where we ate our first meal in Uganda. And that's when we ate matoke for the first time.
Which barracks was that?
Police barracks.
Which one? There are so many police barracks.
In Zambia. That was the only barracks that time. These others are just coming because of this government, change of government. But okay. The original one.
In Zambia.
Zambia.
You went to Zambia.
That's where he prepared us food. Rice, matoke, lumonde. Now, in Zimbabwe, we've got lumonde muzungu. Mm. Lumonde muganda. It is sweeter. That's why it is called sweet potato.
Mm.
It is sweet. You can't mix it with nemva.
Mm.
You can't mix it. You eat it like you boil it and you eat it like a cake. It's sweeter.
Mm.
So we've caught it there. We said, lumonde muganda. It's also part of food. Said, yes. It's part of our food. And this matoke, said, well, I said, how do you, it comes from where this? Said, this is a banana. Then we got confused.
Hmm.
In Zimbabwe, we eat bogoya. That's what we call banana.
You in Zimbabwe, you eat bogoya as what?
As a banana, the way you eat bogoya.
As fruit.
As a fruit.
As a fruit.
Yes. Not but now they're telling us it is food. So we got confused. Matoke is a matoke, but they look the same when they are unripe.
Mm.
They look the same. If you put a toke here and a bogoya here, unless the people who know them seriously, they look the same.
Yeah.
So he told us, oh, this is different matoke. And bogoya, they are different. So we had a full meal there.
Mm.
Then he hired us a house where we were going to stay.
Mm.
Somewhere near the Rubiri in Mengo.
Mm.
And when we got there, he said, that is the Kabaka's palace.
Oh.
We had never seen a big building like that one for an African, because in Zimbabwe at that time, city council, we stay in city council houses. One room, two rooms, or three rooms.
That's which year now we are talking about? Which year? 1950 what?
56.
56 now.
We got in Uganda so 56.
Left Zimbabwe 52.
No. Reaching here
in
56.
Uganda 56.
Yes, before you got independence even.
You came before.
Yes.
Hmm.
Independence got us here. So there's nothing we don't know about Uganda.
we know
Uganda even better than Zimbabwe.
Okay.
So, he showed us the palace.
Mm.
Mm. He said, I want, because people like music from Southern Africa, and you are the first Southern Africans, which means from South Africa, Namibia, or South Africa, that is Southern Africa.
Mm.
Eh? We were the first musicians to come to entertain you here. So he took us to Radio Uganda.
Okay.
To sing and advertise our presence in Uganda.
Yeah.
While we were there singing, there was a big chief of Kabaka. Kiso Sonkore.
I hear. Mulira.
He was a big chief of Kabaka.
Mm.
He went to South Africa for further studies. And he came with a South African wife. Because we speak the same language, Ndebele and Zulu, the same. It's just slightly different. So when she heard our music on the radio, she rang the Uganda radio that those are my people, the wife of Chesonkole. Who was a South African.
Yeah, I know.
She got so excited to hear us sing music from home. She rang the radio that those are my people. I'm Mrs. Chesonkole. I want to talk to somebody. If there's somebody who's nearby, I talk to him. Then they gave Oduka to talk to her. And Oduka said, oh, Oduka knew Chesonkole was royal.
Yeah, yeah.
Big name. So when we finished audition, he said, Nabagamba, I told you, you will not regret coming to Uganda. And now, Murinamu Manyinawan, Manyinamu Aliwa, Mrs. Chesonkole. Akubye simu, Murina Kugenda.
Murubiri.
Ewe.
Ewe.
Ewa bawe. Atukolele party to msisinganeyo, we must confirm, so we confirmed and arranged that we shall come there like this. So we went there. Started speaking in Zulu, even Chesonkole could speak the language. And our sister, she was very happy to see us.
Yeah.
There were some other people who were invited to be with us. That's when Mr. Chesonkole rang to Kabaka.
That?
Asking him if he has heard some people from Southern Africa who are in Uganda, who were singing, who are related to his wife. Mutesa said, yes, I heard that music. Next week, you know, we have got some, entertaining some people in Murubiri. I want them to come. The African king.
Oh my God. Okay. How was it?
You can imagine how excited they were to go and meet an African king
for the first time
in the palace. Good enough. We're good, well behaved. Only one of us was drinking, the rest of us were not drinking at all.
Okay.
So we went. We're all putting on suits.
You went to see the king.
Yes, yes, and we're putting on suits. As we arrived there, we could see people talking, sort of, are these musicians? Because we looked like ministers also.
Oh,
yes.
Very smart.
Very smart. Took our instruments on this, they made a stage, we told them to make a stage. Made a stage for us and a dressing room behind. So the MC was looking after us in the Rubiri. He told us, get ready. The Kabaka, within 20 minutes, he'll be coming out to meet you. We rushed in the dressing room. We changed into uniform. White tuxedo jacket. White shirt, black tie, black trousers, black shoes, black socks.
Very smart.
When they opened the curtain, the king was coming. The people saw us dressed in a different way. That's when the king came. Welcome to Uganda. We hope, these were his words. I hope you like our country. Then he turned to Nabagereka. He spoke in Luganda, we didn't know what he was talking. But he could see, he was talking about the way we are dressed. Then he said, surprising. You are looking so smart.
That was the king saying?
Yes. I've never seen musicians so smart. Talking to Nabagereka. And the people, when they saw us in uniform again, is very smart, they started clapping. and we had made a special program to make sure that King is happy. Mm. He was happy. We were entertained to drinks, food, everything. And he liked us.
Could you please, Mr. Mazo, sample us one of the songs you performed for our king for the first time in our kingdom?
Hamba, hamba, na sokole goli, goli, kuyai wa kappa, kappa sotu nyelwa hamba num sokolo. Ali du lelu, ah, hamba, na sokole goli. Ekoli kuyai wagapa kapa sotu nyelwa hamba nomtsokolo hamba 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 na sokolo goli 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 kuyai wagapa gapa kapa sotu nyelwa hamba nomtsokolo hamba 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 na sokolo goli 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 kuyai wagapa
oh my
gapa,
god
gapa sotu nyelwa hamba nomtsokolo.
It's all about one. What's the meaning of that song?
When you go out, even where you are not known, behave yourself.
Oh, yes.
It is the only way people can respect your presence. If you misbehave,
yeah.
It's not good.
True.
So, and other songs. Each song we sang,
the other meaning.
They were throwing money on the stage.
Oh my God.
Gabatu Fuwa.
Saint.
Saint Kabaka.
He was so excited.
So excited. That's how we became. You see picture there in the house. That's how we became good friends with him.
So, what was your next move after meeting the king, after performing for him? What was your next move?
We, Oduka booked us in Kamuru's Hall.
Okay.
Next to Rubiri. Next to Bulange. The same street with Bulange. There was an Indian called Kamuru who had a nightclub there. So we had our first show there. From there, we went to Budo.
Budo, to do what now?
To stage a show for the students.
Oh.
We went to Makerere.
King's College? You mean
King's College.
Yeah.
And even students rioted there. Because the Muzungu was the headmaster of that school. Unfortunately, what happened? We were supposed to stage a 2-hour show at Budo. But on our way to Budo, we had a breakdown on the way.
Oh, sorry.
We were good timekeepers, but the car broke down. Then was the driver was fidgeting with the, I don't know what happened. Likely enough, after 1 hour, the car became okay. When we reached there, the students were very happy to see us. So they had given up, thought we were not coming. Mm. So we started singing.
So we are talking about 1950, now 1950. 57, 56? You're still in 56?
56.
56.
Mm.
You know Afigo Band?
Even where it started.
you can give us a brief background of Afigo Band, because it's one of our oldest lion.
Yes, it is. In fact, Matovu has done wonders, and I'm so happy.
Mm.
One time I was watching TV, the Katikiro of Buganda, and the King of Buganda, King Mutebi, honored Afigo Band.
Yes.
Because it has resisted all the problems of Uganda.
Hmm.
And it is one of the best bands so far up to date.
Hmm.
Even when they started the website.
Because some of us, we don't know the roots of Afigo Band. How did it come into...
They just got themselves. I don't know how they got themselves and started...
But they formed when you guys were already in the country.
Who?
You guys. Your band was already in the
country. They came later.
They came later?
Yeah, much later. When they were just young boys.
But they are young boys?
Yes, they were young boys.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
They just came later. By that time, even we are even now doing this Susanna Night Club. There's nothing we have not seen. We even went to Gaza to entertain them.
Gaza High.
Yes. Mm. And when we staged a show in Kamuru, which was owned by Muhindi, a Muzungu who was running a nightclub on Kampala Road, opposite what building now? After Uganda House, you go as if you're going to Jinja. It was City Bar there.
Mm.
It was called the Black Cat Nightclub.
Black Cat.
Mm. He came to talk to us. Because by that time now, we had learned how to entertain and play jazz music for people to dance. Mm. We could sing, make a show, and start playing music for people to dance. Mm. The first band to entertain Europeans was us.
It was you.
Black Cat Nightclub. Africans were not allowed there. It was owned by Souza Figueredo, who was a Goan Indian. He himself, too, was not allowed to enter there.
The owner?
Yes. The manager was a Muzungu, a British.
Blacks were not allowed in that club.
Blacks were the...
That club was called? Black?
Black Cat Nightclub.
It was around which place? Between?
Between after,
that's Kampala Road.
After Uganda House, just a bit in front.
Okay.
There was even a South African restaurant which now closed down. Can't remember his name.
Oh my God.
So he told us he wants to give us a job.
In that club?
In that club. He told us he's hiring a band from Italy, accommodating them, transport to and fro when they won't leave. But he want, at least he said the music you are playing is equally the same. Because, you know, as a businessman, obviously I think he paid us half what he pays those Bazungus. Yes. For us, it was a lot of money.
On your side?
Yes. Mm. So we agreed, said after we finish our shows, we shall contact you, we come. And started playing in that Black Cat Nightclub. The barman was an African. The waiters were Africans. Those are the Africans who were there. Maybe
only
the cleaners. Souza Figueredo was the owner, Indian. He would only go there to check the business or sign checks with his Mzungu manager and get out. Not allowed to come there.
So you started performing that club?
Yeah, started performing that club. Now, who comes there?
Who?
Guess who?
I don't know.
Come, Chess.
He came?
I think they told him that those musicians are now playing music for Bazungu. He came. He came with Dr. Kagwa, who was married to a Muzungu wife.
Mm.
They booked. Mrs. Kagwa, the white woman, went and booked a table for about 7-8 people. And when he came, the manager was shocked to see an African. Then he was told that this is the king of Buganda. He said, okay, let me talk to my boss. Then he talked to his boss that the king is here.
Oh my God.
Cutting current here.
Hmm.
What do I do?
Okay.
Good enough. The Muhindi said there's no way you can turn a king
you
away.
You can chase him.
This is the owner of this
How
land.
How can you chase him?
You can't let him come in.
Mm.
By that time, Kilembe Mine
yeah,
was operational. And a lot of Bazungus were from South Africa, Zimbabwe, mm, who were working in that mine.
Okay.
They would travel on weekend, especially Saturday, to come and dance, and Sunday they go back.
Mm.
When they saw Mutesa entering with these people, they left their drinks, their food, and walked out in protest.
Are you for real? They didn't know that the king was
there. They don't want to know those, but those people forget about it. They didn't want to know about who was king forward.
Oh my God. Okay.
These are from South Africa.
Hmm.
They walked out. Almost half.
They never wanted the African or the blacks to mix with them.
No. Those who remained, I think some were civil servants,
hmm,
and business Bazungus. But those from South Africa, they walked out completely.
So they can't mix up.
So we noticed, even him, Mutesa noticed people walking out.
Okay.